As far, therefore, as truths of the understanding are conjoined to goods of the will, thus as far as a man wills truths, and so does them, so far he has heaven in himself, since, as was said above, the conjunction of good and truth is heaven. On the other hand, as far as falsities of the understanding are conjoined to evils of the will, so far man has hell in himself, because the conjunction of falsity and evil is hell. But so far as truths of the understanding are not conjoined to goods of the will, so far man is in a middle state. Almost every man at this day is in such a state that he knows truths from knowledge and also from understanding, thinks them, and either does much of them or little of them, or does nothing of them, or acts contrary to them from the love of evil and consequent faith of what is false. Therefore, in order that he may have either heaven or hell, he is, after death, first brought into the world of spirits, and there the conjunction of good and truth is effected with those who are to be elevated into heaven, and a conjunction of evil and falsity with those who are to be cast into hell. For it is not permitted to anyone in heaven or in hell to have a divided mind, that is, to understand one thing and to will another, but to understand what he wills and to will what he understands. In heaven, then, he who wills good will understand truth, and in hell, he who wills evil will understand what is false. Therefore, with the good, falsities are there removed, and truths are given, agreeable and conformable to their good. And with the evil, truths are removed, and falsities are given, agreeable and conformable to their evil. From these things it is manifest what the world